That satellite dish would have been able to track a Soviet Union missile from about. What's up, guys? So I'm here in Chagamas, which is Trinidad northwestern coastline, and today we're going to be taking a hike to the famous tracking station. I'm here with wifey, and it's about 45 minutes hike up and about 45 minutes down, so let's go. So on this trip, I was lucky to capture the local species of monkeys. Check this out.
A monkey.
If you look at the shape in which the bamboos overlap each other from both sides, it forms a shape something like a cathedral. Hence, they call this area Bamboo Cathedral. So after about 5 minutes walking in flatland, this is where the hill actually starts. Okay, so we now reach the first lookout when you actually head into tracking station and you come across this point. Most people think they reach halfway, but I think the journey has just begun. It's about 25% complete and there's a lot more to go. Check this out. Thank you. people, guys. So if you want to know you're close to the top, while hiking up, you'll see a sign in the ground mark, you're almost there. So it's pretty easy. You'll also come across a Y, and if you head to the left, you'll be going to the satellite dish, and if you head to the right, you'll be going to the tracking station. So I'm at the top of tracking station, or right next to the satellite dish. And fact number one about this place, this very ground that I'm standing on was leased to the US government in the 1940s by the Queen of England. So after World War II and the start of the Cold War, as tensions rose between the US and the Soviet Union, the US saw the need for a head start to the Tikam missile, a Soviet Union missile, against the US, and that is how the early warning system was born. So this tracking station was part of a ballistic missile early warning system commissioned by the US government. This station right here was completed in 1958 and was the first of 12 tracking stations placed around the globe. This one here in Trinidad, our very home, was a prototype using radar technology, which turned out to be successful and led the way to the remaining 11 placed around the globe. Okay guys, so this tracking station right here, I'm on top of the actual tracking station, which is about a 4-story building, and you can see the satellite dish in the background. That satellite dish would have been able to track a Soviet Union missile from about 1500 to 2500 miles away, and it would have given the US military about 15 to 25 minutes early warning so that they could have prepared for the missile attack. Impressive, eh? To add some context to that, the distance between Trinidad and Miami is about 1500 miles. So that's pretty impressive. Imagine everything you're seeing here. This tracking station was commissioned without informing the local authorities in Trinidad and Tobago. So this tracking station was abandoned in 1971 and is now more or less a historical site used by joggers, cyclists and hikers. Okay, so that brings us to the end of this video. I hope it was something that was informative and add some context to this area we visit on an early morning. Okay, so I hope you all enjoyed this video. Be safe and peace out.